Welcome to the HKUST video for undergraduate studies. I am Professor Hoban Chan from the School of Science of HKUST. This is the introduction of our UG program in physics. Let me introduce the physics program in the School of Science of HKUST to you first. Our program does not only train physicists. We train students so they can have the analytical skills to meet the challenge in all sectors of the society. The physics curriculum in HKUST is very flexible to cater for students with different career aspirations. Some of you may want to pursue a master or PhD degree after you graduate from university and attend the best graduate schools abroad. We will provide you with rigorous academic training and research experience to build a strong foundation for further studies. Every year, we have graduates who are accepted by top graduate schools in the world. Many of them have done very well, and some have become professors. About 30% of our graduates pursue the career path of research. Other students will join different sectors in society. What they learn from the physics program is analytical skills and problem-solving methods. This is a simple diagram showing the physics undergraduate program. Each rectangle represents a list of courses a student needs to complete. To graduate from HKUST with a bachelor degree, all students need to complete at least 120 credits. The rectangle here represents a list of courses that all physics students are required to take, such as quantum mechanics and electromagnetism. These courses account for about 100 out of 120 credits. For the remaining 20 credits, students have many different choices. A very popular choice for physics students is to study a minor. About one half of our students choose minors in other subjects, such as computer science, business, actuarial science, math, and sustainable engineering. For those of you who want to study more physics or related topics, we have two options, one track and one extended major. These rectangles represent additional courses in physics, math, or computer science. As an example, we consider the subject of quantum mechanics. It is divided into part one and part two. All physics students are required to study quantum mechanics part one for the basic formalism of quantum mechanics. But not all of them study more advanced topics in part two. Part two is a required course for the honors physics option, that is for students who are interested in a career in research. It gives them more knowledge and more solid foundation to handle the research in future. Physics research can be divided into theoretical and experimental research. Theoretical research often requires additional mathematical skills. The physics and math option is for students interested in theoretical physics. It requires a number of math courses, such as complex analysis and partial differential equation, that other physics students do not need to take. The IRE track is a program in the School of Science where students are guaranteed to have the opportunity for gaining research experience in an international university. The extended major in AI is for physics students to gain additional knowledge of the innovative applications of artificial intelligence. As the name suggests, options are really optional. You do not have to choose any one of them. It is perfectly okay if you want to get a BSc degree without any options on top. Here are some examples of required courses that every physics student must complete. They belong to the top rectangle in the previous slide. They include classical mechanics, electromagnetism, quantum mechanics, thermodynamics and statistical physics, and other lab courses. Elective courses are not compulsory. You can choose to take them or not take them according to your decision. Examples include optics, material science, machine learning, atmospheric physics, and medical physics. There are more than 30 professors in the physics department at HKUST. Their research covers a wide range of areas. We have always been strong in condensed metaphysics and nanoscience. A very important recent development is that our department has expanded into particle physics and cosmology. Particle physics studies the behavior of elementary particles. Cosmology studies the origin, evolution, and the ultimate fate of the universe. We already have two cosmologists, a string theorist, a high-energy theorist, and two experimental high-energy physicists in our department. The department have offered many new courses in these areas, including a minor in astrophysics and cosmology. Courses in this minor include Introduction to Astrophysics and Astronomy, Introduction to Stellar Astrophysics, Particle Physics and the Universe, and Big Bang Cosmology and Inflation. If you are interested in cosmology and particle physics, HKUST is an ideal place to pursue your studies. This is a chart of the career paths of our graduates in one recent year. For our students who choose to pursue further studies, they can compete with students from top universities. Other students go into sectors such as education, government, and industries. To prepare our students for the job market, the physics department have arranged internship opportunities exclusively for physics students. For example, summer internships are offered by these technology companies. One of them makes microscopes with resolution that goes beyond the diffraction limit. The other makes use of metal materials to control acoustic noise. The third one makes magnetic resonance imaging systems. The middle panel is for internship in a secondary school. These students are interested in becoming secondary school teachers, and they spent their summer to gain experience in teaching secondary school students. Following up on the expansion of our research into particle theory and cosmology that I mentioned earlier, we have an arrangement with CERN for summer fellowships. You might have heard of the discovery of the Higgs boson, and CERN is where the Large Hadron Collider is located. If you apply for the undergraduate program through JUPAS, HKUST has the general admission requirement. The minimum level is 332233. You can refer to this table for the details. For admitting into the Science A or Science B program in the School of Science, we are using this JUPAS admission formula. We are counting the 5 best subjects of your DSE scores, in which some relevant science subjects would be weighted. For more details, you can check with this table. Since we are using school-based admissions, if you want to pursue a physics major, you should select Science Group A or Science Group A plus AI program as your first choice. Other than JUPAS admission, if you are a direct entry student who is using international qualifications such as IB, GCE A-level, or SAT to apply for the undergraduate program, you are welcome to visit our website for more information or contact us through email directly. Thank you for watching the video. I hope you have better knowledge about our physics program. Finally, I look forward to seeing you at our campus in the near future. Bye.